Exactly 1 year ago today, on June 24th of 2024, behind me the scene would have looked strikingly different. Water would have been ripping through here after 8.5 inches of rain struck the watershed, the Blue Earth River watershed, over the preceding 2 days from about June 22nd to June 24th. Early in the morning, water rose up and around the dam and started to essentially slice through the landscape that you can see behind me, leaving kind of this massive chasm erosional system that we see here. We were first out here on July 3rd of 2024. To be able to start monitoring how this system is changing. As you can see the cracking right there.
Yeah.
So we're not going to want to get too close. Part of this, you know, here at Eau Claire, we value and truly care about undergraduate experiences and undergraduate research opportunities. As an alum, a very proud alum of Eau Claire, it was those formative experiences that made me want to take the path that led me to be here today.
I was actually doing some work with the Mankato crew in the Duluth area when this event happened, or right before it. We were driving home trying to beat the storm that actually would end up kind of causing this whole thing. My advisor reached out to me after they had gotten this project approved, asking if this was a project I wanted to be a part of. So it was one of the first like intensive projects that I've been working on. And
she has been the undergraduate collaborator tied to this research project since we started it back in 2024. She has been out here flying drones, doing processing, presenting at international conferences, and really showing Eau Claire and the world what it means to be an Eau Claire geographer and an Eau Claire undergraduate.
We have a little mini orange drone that we use to get kind of repeat imagery that starts turning, and then it automatically goes up a little bit by itself, and then you'll use this left joystick here. We try to hit kind of the crucial areas. So right here, the shadow bar behind the dam, we like to look at how that's been developing and then how this bank is changing. We try to get kind of repeat imagery to kind of show how that change has been happening over these months. What we're able to do with the big drone that's flying is we're able to understand like exactly how much sediment has been eroded and deposited. We use some programming on the computer to be able to calculate that.
Pretty wild.
I'm really curious to see what it looks like now.
Yeah, me too. That's actually great. If we just get through here, we've got a nice little sandbar that we can at least get onto. So here it is. It kind of looks like a Martian cert, right? It's just sand and rocks just ripped apart. So again, if we can think of what this was before the dam actually went, or the river ate around the dam, everything was up to the level of those trees you see over there. That little tiny knob that we were looking at
on the
map, that's it. And everything was at that level, and at the level we were just standing on a little bit further back. You know, the topography is generally flat, but there's all these like low points and whatnot. And that's where different parts of the channel was ripping through all the sediment as the system was evolving in a matter of hours.
There's a difference between learning something in the classroom and then actually seeing something in real life. So being able to work on this hands-on and seeing like the power of water and the power that humans have for and natural disasters have for modifying the environment has been really impactful for me. And has inspired me partially to go to grad school and continue potentially looking at water systems like this. My experience with geography, I feel like I have so many mentors that I've gained from it. Like, I feel like I know the professors really, really well, and it's just been a really like nurturing environment for me to be able to like expand as a student and prepare for grad school. So.